taking a little longer, you know, on Sunday. I know none of you would feel that way, right? But my parents taught me before the end of the year, every year you have to pay all of your bills so you don't owe anyone anything on January the 1st. So my homily will be brief today to pay back any of the minutes or two that I have maybe gone a little long, huh? I share one thought with you and a little poem story with you as we prepare for Christmas this Advent day. You know, we're in the year of mercy, and if you've been following in the bulletin, I've been reflecting really on that meaning of mercy. So very often we just reduce it to that moment that we physically leave this world and stand before God and rely on his mercy, his forgiveness for us to be eternal in heaven. But that call of mercy from our Holy Father to reflect upon this year is so much broader. And I think one element among many of the element of mercy is the time that we have. And the season of Advent is really a season of a call of mercy to properly use our time, to be ready. And maybe to follow the wise example of our Blessed Mother in the Gospel today, we hear that it was in haste, meaning quickly, she went to take care of her cousin Elizabeth. Very often in the Gospels, we see that someone is given a mission and sent on their way. And in the Gospel, we also hear, go and learn the meaning of the words. It is mercy that I desire and not sacrifice. So reflecting on that sense of mercy, all of us in the Gospel have that mandate, that mission to learn the meaning of the words. It's mercy I desire, not sacrifice. Is there anything really in this Advent season that we've not yet addressed in our own life of faith, our own relationships with one another, in order to make that road to our Lord Jesus straight? And if we identify something, make haste, as Mary did, to learn the words of mercy and articulate that. Think about that as you listen to this little story. 'Twas the night before Jesus came. 'Twas the night before Jesus came, and all through the house, not a creature was praying, not one in the house. Their Bibles were laying on the shelf without care, in hopes that Jesus would not come there. The children were dressed to crawl into bed, not once ever kneeling or bowing a head. And Mom, in her rocker with baby on her lap, was watching the late show while I took a nap. When out of the east there arose such a clatter, I sprang to my feet to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but angels proclaiming that Jesus was here. With a light like the sun sending forth a bright ray, I knew in a moment this must be the day. The light of his face made me cover my head. It was Jesus returning, just as he had said. And though I possess worldly wisdom and wealth, I cried when I saw him in spite of myself. In the book of life which he held in his hand was written the name of every saved man. He spoke not a word as he searched for my name. When he said, it's not here, my head hung in shame. The people whose names have been written with love he gathered to take to his Father above. With those who were ready, he rose without a sound while all the rest were standing around. I fell to my knees, but it was too late. I waited too long and thus sealed my fate. I stood and I cried as they rose out of sight. Oh, if only I had been ready tonight. In the words of this poem, the meaning is clear. The coming of Jesus is drawing near. There's only one life, and when comes the last call, we'll find out that the Bible was true after all.